A massive welcome to Keep Britain Singing with Rock Choir. Thanks for joining us. Every day we are here at 3 p.m. to bring you some singing fun, free warm-ups, and a variety of our brilliant Rock Choir songs. Now, I know many of you have been joining every day to get your singing fix, but of course, a massive welcome if you're here for the first time. My name's Abigail Harris, and I'm a leader for some of the Hertfordshire choirs, Watford, St. Albans, and Hertford. Hello, lovely Rockies. And I've taught rock choirs for, I think, just over 10 years now, and I simply love our rehearsals. They're like big parties. Of course, at the moment, we're meeting virtually, and we're just hoping we can bring our infectious singing into your homes. It's a great opportunity to get your families involved as well, so if they've run off, get them back, call them. It's almost a bank holiday, the sun's shining, we're going to get moving. Get some space around you, and we're just going to do some shoulder rolls. Ease out any tension. Let's feel the beat with a little click. Are you ready? Up to your ears. Here we go. We're going to do a little click with the hands, swaying out. Really feel that beat, get energized. What have you been doing today? I want to know. You can type it in the comments for me. Maybe you've been in the garden. Brilliant. Now it is 3 o'clock. It's that mid-afternoon slump. So let's wake up our bodies and brains a little bit now. What I'd like you to do is this bit of body percussion rhythm. Don't panic, it's nothing too difficult. But it's a clue to the song we're going to learn today. So the rhythm is, we're going to do a stamp, thigh, thigh, slap. Okay? So it's going to go like this. You're going to go stamp, thigh, thigh, chest, chest, clap, clap, click. Stamp, thigh, thigh, chest, chest, clap. Good. Preferably your own chest and your own thighs. Stamp, thigh, thigh, chest, chest, clap, clap, click. You got it. Stamp, thigh, thigh, chest, chest, clap, clap. Good, keep it going. Stamp, thigh, thigh. Want to say a big smile too? Brilliant, let's clap above our heads. A bit of a party. If you've just joined us, we're Key Britain Singing with Rock Choir. Huge welcome. We're just warming up and we're going to be singing. We're just getting relaxed. Fantastic. Give yourselves a round of applause. Lovely. Hopefully you're feeling nice and relaxed and energised now. And if you've just joined us, hi, we are Rock Choir at Keep Britain Singing. Thanks for tuning in. We're about to get our body kind of physically aligned now before we start some vocal warm-ups. So just check for me that you're standing nice and tall, your feet are just hip width apart, and your arms are relaxed by the side. Just imagine as well that someone's talking about you and you're trying to hear, and your ears are just gonna prick up ever so slightly. So you stretch the back of your neck as well, and it just lifts you. Hopefully you've all grown an inch or two there. To show you the difference with singing, it is really important that we keep straight. And just to demonstrate that for you, if you speak the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 repeatedly and just start off with a kind of scruffed neck for me and then gradually grow, you'll hear the difference. So if you just try it now, start off in a sort of teenage slump. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There is quite a difference with that. So just make sure that your pipe here isn't bent at all. Now, another bit of singing sort of technique for you. I just want to wake up the abdomen. So have you ever laughed or cried so much it hurts? Maybe in a rock choir rehearsal. I know we have lots of fun. Tell me in the comments, like and tell me in the comments here. It's a busy muscle, the abdomen, and it's an important one to remember in singing. So just below the belly button, yes, for me that area has grown quite a lot during lockdown. Have you all been eating? It's all about the meals, isn't it? So what we're going to do is wake it up with a few silly sounds. So just below your belly button, you're feeling there that band of muscle. Can you do that motorbike revving or dentist drill, dare we think of it? You should feel it nice and flexible. Imagining some nice cake food again. Brilliant. Let's just get the breath working properly. I mean, hopefully you're breathing right now, but take a breath in through the mouth and out through the mouth. This time, try and imagine, I don't know, like Popeye, you're really filling up. Embrace those failed New Year lockdown diets and just let it all hang out. Sort of the opposite of OK Magazine, yeah? We're going to fill up. So you're going to breathe in and then out. Keep it going. And then once you're done, let everything splat. Just release it. No one's watching. Let's do the same. Let's do a breathing in and keep it going. Keep it going. Don't cheat. Keep it going. Nice, consistent. And then let it just splash. Splash, splat. That's the one I was looking for. Well done. So now you're standing tall and we've got our breath flowing nicely. We're just going to have a hum through Over the Rainbow. It's quite a gentle one to ease us in. So join with me just with a gentle hum to start, but with the lips slightly parted. Okay, here we go. So we've got... Lovely stuff. So what we're going to do now is just see if you can breathe once, only once in the middle. So you've got that first bit. Keep going, keep going, keep going with a really smooth sound. And if you can feel a little tingle in your nose, at the front of your mouth, on your lips, that's a really good sign because it means you're projecting and you're not holding the sound in here. Because of course, your neighbours want to hear you sing, don't they? And I certainly want to hear you sing. So, bit of a hum still, lips slightly parted, breathing low. See if you can go through just one breath. Challenge yourselves. Get that buzz as well. Excellent. So this time, can you open out to an E? So this is a really lovely warm sound. Check that your tongue's nice and high. So we're going to do it to E. Give it lots of air. Here we go. E. There's your breath. E. What about R? Well done. I hope you're starting to release those gorgeous voices. I know it feels really strange singing on your own, although we have a lot of husbands and wives in our choirs too, and whole families, in fact. I once had, it was a daughter, a mother and a grandma all in the same choir, and they would drive to rehearsals singing with each other in harmony. I think it was a bit like the Von Trapp family. Right, what we're going to do now is a tongue twister. Do you have a favourite tongue twister? Let me know. I'm sure you've been doing lots of these in your choir rehearsals, or if you're just joining us, I'm sure you know a few anyway. We're going to do a new one for my members, actually. St Albans, Hertford, Watford. You haven't done this before. Let me know how you get on. We're going to do Saturday matinee repeatedly. Saturday matinee. Saturday matinee. I'm rubbish at these. Give it a go. So we're going to go up the scale. Saturday matinee, Saturday matinee, Saturday matinee, Saturday matinee. Back down the stairs. Saturday matinee, Saturday matinee, Saturday matinee, Saturday matinee. I'm sure you're much better than me. And this is, I'm horrendous at this one. Cucumber, cucumber. Good luck. Cucumber, 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 cucumber. Bit too fast, wasn't it? Next up, we're going to do a little warm-up based on Car Wash. I love that song. And it's just going to be a loop that kind of repeats. But it's to get you relaxing your jaw now, because actually as singers, or anyway, we all hold quite a bit of tension here. So I want you to think of, I don't know, Gordon Brown. So it's very relaxed, or maybe you've had one too many glasses of vino. And it's just really relaxed here, but you're still nice and bright. I always say to my singers, you know, have your eyebrows on, cheekbones up. So you're still nice and smiley here, but this is all really relaxed. And it's a bit of scat singing, so it doesn't really matter what sound you make, but da-da-da-da, that kind of thing. You'll pick it up. I'll put the track on. Let's have a go together. You can move around. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da Yeah. Up another step. One more time. Amazing. Give yourselves a round of applause. Now, I hope you didn't just hear, but my dog, Charlie, was just howling along outside the door a minute ago. He just sings with everything. It's impossible to work. He's definitely a soprano. Do you have a talented pet? Do you have a dog that howls along with you? Let me know in the comments. I'd like to hear from you. Thank you so much for joining us here. 3 p.m. Keep Britain Singing with Rock Choir. We've been here every day since the start of lockdown. We're going to continue to keep everyone singing and enjoying singing with us. I need to say thank you to all my amazing colleagues who have been taking these sessions, and they're doing a sterling job. I'm sure you'd agree. Thanks for your amazing feedback. A special shout out to my London team, Nick, who's in his very first year of teaching choirs. Simon, did you see Simon's dog the other week? Oh my goodness, how cute is that dog? Elliot, Michael, are you in their choirs? Big hi to you. Nicola, Katie, Rachel, who dept for me last term. I've just had a baby, and she taught my choirs and was absolutely amazing. And Christina, you've just had a baby boy. Timothy, I'm sure we'd all love to send our love to you. Huge congratulations. You've got quite a story to tell, I think. 20 minutes to spare upon arrival at Watford Hospital. Sounds pretty exciting. But yeah, we really appreciate you all joining us here. And it's so exciting that technology allows us to kind of continue in some capacity. So we're moving into Walking on Broken Glass, Annie Lennox's famous song here. One of my favourite rock choir pieces. No, it's the favourite. It's my absolute favourite. It gives me goosebumps every time. I have three members, particularly in the St. Albans Morning Choir, Claire, Elaine and Jill, who give a squeal every time I say we're going to run this. It's just a brilliant sing, and I hope you enjoy it too. So we're going to run it through, and if you haven't sung with us before, you can sing the tune with me. Everyone else, you'll know your harmonies. Hopefully you'll remember them. Let's just pick up a little corner to remind us this is the bridge. So we're going to be doing... times, and on the fourth time, I'll signal four when we get to it in a minute, you're going to open out to a big R, as big as you can. I want to hear you wherever you are. Do it again. Amazing. And it's followed by two stamps and two claps at the same time. So like this, you're going to go stamp, stamp, as loud as you can. It's a good release of any, it's a real stress buster, this song. And I remember 1500 Rockies, were you there? 1500 Rockies singing this on the pitch at Wembley Stadium to 90,000 people. And it was just an incredible moment. And I sang solo with you, and it was hilarious, actually. In the soundtrack, the rugby players kept getting closer to us with the rugby ball as we were trying to warm up and sing. And then we were told we couldn't move on the pitch. It became impossible. We had great fun that day. Who was at the O2? Another place. We're just listing all the places we've been. Some amazing memories created. So we're going to run it through now. Okay, so again, check you've got some space around you. And I'll just get the track up and we'll run it through. Sing along with me on the tune if you haven't sung this with us before. I'm going to play along with the piano as well. And move, you know, click, clap, enjoy it. What's that saying? Dance like no one's watching, sing like no one's listening. I want to hear you all the way over here in Hertfordshire. Here we go.
You were the sweet. sweetest thing I ever knew. But I don't care for sugar, honey.
For singing along there. I don't even notice at the start, my postman came up the drive, so I gave him a little wave. You were just marvellous. I hope you enjoyed that. Well done, everyone. Now, we're here every day at 3 p.m. Keep Britain Singing with Rock Choir. Please keep tuning in, because there's going to be a different song every day for you to get stuck into. And if you fancy singing even more with us, you could always head to the website rockchoir.com and find out a little bit more about joining our virtual sessions this term. Beyond that, we rehearse up and down the country with choirs in many different locations. There's bound to be a choir near you. It's a great way to make new friends. You don't have to audition. You don't have to read music. We just have a brilliant time. And I know I've had the privilege of meeting so many wonderful people on my rock choir journey, say over 10 years now. We've done some amazing performances together. So we went to Paris and we sang outside the Magic Castle. 300 rock choir members sang there with me. The flash mob on the ferry crossing over to France was interesting, as we sang Rather Be and the boat was going like this. And we also sang, and it was really poignant because it was just following the terror attacks in Paris. We sang in the Notre Dame Gardens. And we performed Something Inside So Strong, which was just so emotional. So let me know what you've done with your choirs. If you're a rockie out there, I want to hear, put it in the comments, and I'd love to hear what your most memorable event or performance was. And as I say, if you fancy joining us virtually this term, I know we're having great fun. This week in my choirs, we've been having cheese and wine evenings. So we've been singing over the internet to each other, enjoying our cheese and wine, which has been a real giggle. So just go to rockchoir.com and you can find more information. Now, each day in these 3 p.m. sessions, a little challenge has been set for you, or you've been asked to tell us something. So my what I'd like to do is to get you telling me your misheard lyrics. My mum, who's in rock choir, has been from day one. She is notorious for mishearing songs. Maybe you learnt a song with us in rock choir and it was like a revelation because the words were totally different to what you've been singing for many years. An example of my mum, she's always sung There's Mud on the Dance Floor. I think she thought it was a song about cleaning up mud on a dance floor. And another rock choir member was telling me when we learnt Living on a Prayer that they always thought it was, it doesn't make a difference if we're naked or not, rather than make it or not. It doesn't make a difference if we're naked or not. Changes the whole meaning, doesn't it? So have you misheard any lyrics? Let me know now, put it in the comments, and I'd love to hear from you. I really hope you've enjoyed our sing together. I know I have. My name's Abigail, I'm a leader for rock choir. Thank you for tuning in. And of course, a massive thank you to our NHS and our care workers, teachers out there, everyone that is doing all they can to really help us stay safe. So yeah, stay safe and keep singing. And you'll have a blast tomorrow with Lizzie Dean, who will be leading the 3 p.m. session. Lots of love, everyone. Thank you. Bye.